absolutely no mana. Blizzo has no defenses. It's going to be a race to the finish.
Waz needs to find some pressure here. Needs to take down Blizzo. Stun on the Looney. Can they take Blizzo down in this moment? Jazz almost into execute range. XRB close
to get Waz out of their face, but he Cloak of Shadows. He doesn't care. He wants them stacked up so he can attack whoever doesn't have Earth Shield. They might need to use the gateway very shortly. Swapsy moves in with Tricks of the Trade. They swap to Looney. No trinket. Tons of damage. Method Black come. Chaz has no Vim. He's completely tapped. His team is all dead. It's all Looney just has to stay alive a little bit longer. This could easily go down to a 2v2. Gouge under the way of the crane, trying to stall it out into a full psychic scream.
Swapsy
still trying to stall it out, but swap. Looney's wave the crane threat completely from this match.
Yeah, Waz charging in, snap on Looney. They want to get aggressive right away. All three members of Method Black on Blizzo. Chaz going to be mounting in for a nice fear on the Looney. They're looking for that damage. Stun over on the Z5 right away. Looney still caught into the fear. Z5 goes down to around 50% HP, but he should be fine. Looney able to just free cast some heals for now, but that was a good opener for Method Black.
Yep, decent pressure, but not really pulling any major defensive cooldowns. They swap to Blizzo for a moment. Looney's getting primed and ready, but there's a lot of chain lightning out of nowhere from Swapsy, taking the entire team down to half health, but Looney can reset his team's health with that Way of the Crane. He's building up stacks with Tiger Pop. He's ready to do a blackout kick. It's going to hit three times and heal his whole team basically back to full in a second here. Looney's team bounces back, and now they've got the bonus damage, but he gets Psychic Screamed on it. Perfect crowd control from Chaz as they swap to Blizzo.
Whoa!
What
my
just
goodness!
Happened
what?
To Blizzo? He just got deleted! Deleted from the game! His character doesn't exist anymore, it's gone!
It's called Plunder Armor. Tricks of the Trade, Plunder Armor, Elemental Shaman. One good setup.
See a setup on Looney, and Waz gets punished. Good teamwork from Blizzo, taking a page out of Chun-Li's book and trying to play backup for his healer. Waz is not able to get anything done with that attempt, and now we're in a position where XRB to the Moon have trinkets on all three players and major defensive cooldown, so they can deflect an attack, but they need to be careful. If they can bait out a trinket here, that will be deadly later on. Blizzo is being safe, though. Looney times the heals, picks them back up. Good recovery.
Yeah, Looney's gonna be might have to be careful with his mana a little bit later on in this game. Meth Black's doing a good job bouncing around, but so far, XRB to the Moon's doing a good job deflecting it. Big swap on Looney, though. Pistol stun into Cheap Shot into Gouge, and they take him down!
Whoa.
What was that damage? The game-winning Gouge coming in from Waz, denying anything from Looney. That was absolutely insane.
He just turned Looney into a volleyball. He just served him up, and Swapsy just spiked him down.
That Gouge, I can't believe, I gotta see the replay.
I looked
it
over
with this Polymorph and Rookie, but I'm not sure they're gonna even get it.
The move had such a good opener. Minpoike used Trinket, Sacrifice, as well as that Blessing of Protection. Now Alex in a lot of trouble with the Fear on Minpoike. Alex getting lower and lower, spamming out the Polymorphs. He gets Windjeared, nicely done by Astro. Is this gonna be the Cauterize and Ice Block? Cheap Shot in Minpoike. Cauterize is used as well as the Ice Block. The move is destroying Temple Storm.
These Hexes from Absturge have been so critical to just locking Minpoike, the healer for Tempo Storm, out of the game, and they could just close the match with it. Windshirt onto the Polymorph. Absurge gets Dragon's Breath away, but will Alex survive? He blinks one shadow where death connects. Alec is hiding behind the pillar, but that Shadow Crash sneaks around the corner. Peekaboo moves in. There's almost absolutely nothing left to keep Alec going, and he will fall in game number one. Strategy torn apart by pure experience.
That is the move that was dominant in NA. That is what NA has to offer. Starting off the day with a victory.
Nixie leaps over, disarms Peekaboo. Vendetta is ticking 3 seconds away from that Astral Shift. Wilman Poike choke in this position. He trades out the Astral Shift, jumps to the gate. He can make a getaway if he needs to, but he's playing a dangerous game, but Nixie's dangerously low as well. He may need to gate behind the pillar. Wilman Poike be able to pick his team back up with almost nothing left Spearling Totem, but Alex not there. He's rooted too far away. His team is just rotting down. Nixie's so dangerously low. Minpoike holds on by a thread.
Kidney shot him, Minpoike. This could be it for the move. They could take him down right here. Minpoike, how are you going to handle this situation? Nice Spearling Totem coming in. Alec was there. That was so key for their team to survive. Silence out on Minpoike still. Just so much pressure coming in from the move. Minpoike, he has to play like a god in this situation.
He has nothing left, and Whiskey's right in front of him, but Absurge gets fully hexed, but it breaks. Minpoike gets kicked. Peekaboo looking for the solo kill. Whiskey's Shadow Crash comes crashing in and takes them out. The move are all about aggression in this series, now leading the series 2-0.
And that Shadow Crash is going to send Minpoike straight to the Shadow Realm. The move firing on all
needs to connect a big hit to top himself. He's dangerously low. They knock Chaz away. Looney hangs on. Shaylun's Gift should top him back off, but Chaz is now the one on the back foot, and XRB to the Moon are looking like they can close this.
They might have found the composition. Chaz completely Stormbolt on Waz. He does have the trinket, opting not to use it in execute range. Blizzo trying to kill him. Incapacitate on Chaz. Blizzo trying to connect. There's a defensive blind coming in from Waz. That's a big offensive tool that he had to use defensively, but he had no choice in that situation. XRB to the moon has found so much pressure and so much momentum.
Chaz has no Vim. He's completely tapped. His team is all dead. It's all, Looney just has to stay alive a little bit longer. This could easily go down to a 2v2. Gouge under the way of the crane, trying to stall it out into a full psychic scream.
Swapsy
still trying to stall it out, but Swapsy falls first. And they've done it. They've beaten the final boss. They've beaten the Pirates in game number one.
That is a crazy start to for XRB. I mean, ultimately, you kind of walk into this series and just expect a swift
Waz, I think he's just waiting for his blind. He's going to be able to blind up Looney, go on to Blizzo with everything, and they can take him down. Walrick's still rotting down as well. Swapsy and Chaz causing a lot of pressure. Blizzo trying to force Waz in a defensive position, but a nice interrupt from Waz onto Looney, not allowing him to pop off, but a big swap over on Walrick's, forcing out his Trinket, Unending Resolve, and the Hellstone. Method Black is on fire.
All right, with no pillars to portal behind, Method Black are pulling a ton of cooldowns. You can tell that they are now taking this series seriously because at this point, everybody is exposed to go down. How is Looney going to predict it? They're forced to stack up in the room. They're pinned down. Method Black have them in a position to take this match. Let's see if they can do it. Fist of Fury onto Waz. They're trying to force him away. They need to get Waz out of their face, but he Cloak of Shadows. He doesn't care. He wants them stacked up so he can attack whoever doesn't have Earth Shield. They might need to use the gateway very shortly. Swapsy moves in with Tricks of the Trade. They swap to Looney. No Trinket. Tons of damage. Method Black come back. And now they're bringing this series. We've got a good series on our hands here, ladies and gentlemen, because that didn't look like any of the other earlier games.
That was checkmate for XRB to the moon. Looney had no Trinket. Walrick's had no Trinket.
Chaz stacking up Clarity of Wills on Waz as he is the expected target. That's good, a premeditative move. Waz grappling, hooking back to the top of the ramp, but really not getting anywhere. Blizzo goes into battle stance, goes for a Stormbolt. Chaz life grips away. Blizzo reconnects. Looney on top of him for the paralysis as well, but does not want to overcommit. They know they win in dampening, so using Way of the Crane aggressively would be a mistake for Looney. He's playing it patient.
Yeah, interrupt on the Chaz. Waz still in a lot of trouble, forced into the Cloak of Shadows. Z-Fi kiting away. Looney now getting swapped through, uses the Way of Crane to survive. He has a cocoon, and once again, Blizzo is going to have that fear, which is just so important to keep them alive. But if Method Black can save their trinkets for that moment, they can take Looney down.
And they all have their trinkets, both Swapsy and Waz. Looney may even need to pre-life cocoon this next stun. He's trying to get aggressive, though, with Waz human racialing out of that Stormbolt. Looney's in a position defensively at the room to try and make them overextend so Z-Fi can free cast on them. But any Earthshock here, Earthshock, grappling hook, stun, wombo combo. Is Blizzo going to be able to save him in these final moments as he's getting bursted down? No, he will not be able to. Swapsy's damage just a little bit too much, and we're going to be tying this series up, ladies and gentlemen.
And that is the threat in these waters when you're playing against Waz. Every single game, you need to know that is something that is always
in the realm of Waz.
He's
being very greedy in this position, but he is going to get away with it, rolling away to safety. And every time he's able to get away from those situations, it opens up the potential to be more aggressive in the future.
At this point of the game, the Looney's going to have to cast out a lot more Enveloping Mist, really taxing his mana. Waz gets the gouge on Looney. Chaz in position to land the fear. A lot of damage now on the Blizzo. Looks like Z-Fi is actually the main target. Swapsy just stalling him down. Can they take him down? Life Cocoon in the nick of time coming in from Looney to keep Z-Fi alive.
This is the swing match in the final series. Best of seven in the summer finals. Will XRB to the moon be able to stay alive long enough? Their defensive cooldowns are rotating up. They're looking good. Chaz is almost tapped on mana. Double stun secured from Looney as Chaz is dipping low. That Vim is gone, and who knows when it's going to be back with dampening ramping up so heavily. Waz dipping down below half. Swapsy getting hexed away. He can't help anybody. And XRB to the moon, they're looking solid.
They're looking very solid. Way of the Crane's going to be available. Z-Fi has his Astral Shift. Everyone from XRB is safe. Incapacitate on Chaz. Can they take Waz down? Riposte going to be traded out to avoid some of the damage coming in from Blizzo. He leaps away, but Chaz, with this amount of mana at this point, dampening is going to be so hard. Like we said, to get that precious Vim up, which increases his healing. If they can keep this pressure up on Chaz, it's going to be very scary for Method Black.
Blizzo charging. If they stack up for a triple Bladestorm, that could just be the end of the game. Nice off pummel from Blizzo, trying to get the pressure, but Light's Wrath potentially. We see all the interrupts have been blown through. Looney moves in. He's got Trinket. He's got Way of the Crane. He's got everything to keep his team going. He might have to Trinket out of this. He's being greedy. Blizzo's trying to sit through it as well. Die by the Sword available, holding on to everything so they can make a final push, but they're risking it. He's dangerously low. All the bursts are flying in. He's going to use a commanding shot, but he's still dipping low. Way of the Crane. remain on 10%, but they do not care. They're going to be gunning down Chaz, trying to stay on target. Chaz is looking to kite away. Blizzo not able to stay on target just yet, but he's not going to get that Vim back. Chaz has absolutely no mana. Blizzo has no defenses. It's going to be a race to the finish.
Waz needs to find some pressure here. Needs to take down Blizzo. Stun on the Looney. Can they take Blizzo down in this moment? Chaz almost into execute range. XRB closing out the game. They're going to be leading.
Wait, maybe a cross kill
on Blizzo. Ultimately, Z-Bot lands some healing staff on the Looney. Does have the life cocoon, and that will secure their victory. XRB still in a commanding lead, not losing that precious swing match.
Black still available for Waz.
Black can get their footing in this matchup. There are a few opportunities here. Walrus, no trinket, no unending resolve. Looney, no trinket. They can get a blind setup with the plunder armor. This is going to be devastating for XRB.
We're just moving deeper and deeper into dampening, now almost at 30%. These healers will not be able to recover from the high intensity burst much longer. Raikou has frozen orb. They've got plunder. Looney's got no trinket. Walrus has nothing. At this point, Method to Black have probably one more opportunity to take a kill. Walrus is caught in Frost Nova right now. He can't run. Waz is overextending though. He trinkets. He's forced to retreat away. Blizzo says, no way you're killing my warlock. Playing defense perfectly, counter pressuring Waz. Chaz pains suppressions, but now he can't push forward. Vortex onto Waz to try and get the grappling hook. He pre-bears the blind. There's no swap opportunity. Walrus gates away. Waz in hot pursuit. He has to solo Walrus. Blizzo leaps back to defend, but he might be able to do it. He doesn't. He takes them down. We're going to game number 7.
One more game is going to decide the second team to go to BlizzCon. What a series that we are having
behind the pillar, waiting for Method Black to make a move. Waz caught into a Stormbolt Paralysis. Good cross crowd control. Waz, he overreacts. He trades almost his entire defensive arsenal early on.
They want to get aggressive on Z-Bi. Gouge on the Looney. Big burst on the Z-Bi right now. Waz holding the Plunder Armor, but are they going to be able to get the Astral Shift? Z-Bi playing it a little bit greedy. Looney's in a good position to heal him up, but he gets blinded. He trinkets out with the Revival. Method Black making sure XRB to the Moon is having to play very defensively.
All right, Z-Bi on the run. Looney has no trinket, no way of the Crane. They could easily swap to him and just crush him outright. He has to predict the next attack, or he's going to be removed from the tournament, not going to BlizzCon. Waz is putting up the pressure. There's the Gouge to set up for the kill. Swaps the Enchas, moving in. Where's the stun? There it is. Blizzo needs to do something soon. He pre-dived by the swords. They actually swapped to Blizzo. They saw the preemptive wall. Will he go down through the pre-dive by the sword? He quite possibly could. He
does.
And Black have done it. They're going to BlizzCon.
Absolutely insane to close that game out in that fashion. Method Black. What?